Groucho and the Marx Brothers' parents, Frenchie and what was her name? The mother. They were German immigrants, German Jewish immigrants, who came here, long before World War II or something like that. They would have been fried had they stayed,
right,
in Europe. Those kind of immigrant rhythms. Now, Groucho was an autodidact. That is, he had a sixth grade education and resented his mother very much taking him out of school to be in show business. Minnie, because there was a musical called Minnie's Boys about Minnie and Frenchie. Frenchie was the father. And he taught himself. You know, he read all of Dickens. He read a lot of philosophy. And that's a good word you can use at a cocktail party. Autodidact.
Yeah, I was going to say, where's my thesaurus?
The rest were morons. The fact that they make a big deal that Harpo, who was apparently the greatest man, that he just never had an enemy, but they make him out to be some intellectual at the famous round table at the Algonquin Hotel, because they adored him, the intellectuals, but he himself, I read his book, which he didn't write. I'll tell you quickly, and then I have you take over your own show. There was an article about me in the Sunday Times, a big spread number of years ago, made a point. I'm playing all these theaters, in the 70s. And it was like a new vaudeville. Hey, people are playing theaters again. All these converted into movie theaters and now, live entertainment again, even though they were originally vaudeville. I get a letter. Oh, then I hosted The Tonight Show for the first time. I guess I hosted it about 15 times. And I was on the show a total of, with Johnny, 97 times.
Wow.
When I was on with Jimmy a couple of years ago, before the plague, they gave me a plaque with every performance on The Tonight Show with the date. I think it was 97. In any case, I get a letter from Groucho Marx. I saw you hosting a Tonight Show. You were fantastic. That girl was talking about cockroaches and Bernadette Peters. She was adorable, but he didn't like her talking about cockroaches. And you saved her and blah, blah, blah. I laughed so hard, I almost fell off my secretary's knee, he said. He said, when you come out to California, give me a call and I'll buy you dinner. If I really like you, I'll buy you breakfast too.
Wow.
So I go out to California to do a part in Love American Style. Are you too young for that?
No, I remember it quite well, actually.
Yeah. And we're shooting at Paramount, and I call Groucho, but we're going to be shooting at night. So I go, Groucho, it's Robert Klein. You remember? I remember. Every time I would tell old people like George Burns my name, which is polite, and I forget names and nouns. You may have to help me. It's part of being old. They said, I know. So I said, well, you invited me for dinner. He said, well, can you come for dinner? I said, I can't come for dinner because we're shooting at night. Oh, and he said, well, can you come for dinner? I said, well, Groucho, we're shooting at night. He said, well, can you come for dinner? So I don't know if it's mini strokes or he's putting me on. So I said, well, you said if you really like me, you give me breakfast. He said, well, come for breakfast. So I went to his house in Beverly Hills. Beautiful house, a little bit run down. There's a gorgeous nurse attending him without a nurse's thing on, just a beautiful young woman. He had a hospital bed. He had had a little stroke or something, but he got out of it. He was running around in these black pajamas, chasing a cat. It was funny. So I asked him, among other things, what's the definitive book about the Marx Brothers? Because I'm such a fan. I said, is it Harpo Speaks? He says, Harpo didn't write that, Wow. Right away he came in, because he wrote his own books, which I value too. Harpo Speaks had no with so-and-so, it was just that. Then he pointed to his honorary Oscar and the picture of Erin Fleming, who was his companion. She was about 35 years old. She gave him new life, He says, I don't drink, I don't smoke, I don't fuck, he said. And he said, if I had to give up one of these two, and he points to his Oscar and a picture of Erin, he said, I give up the Oscar. And she came about 2 hours after I'm sitting there. She surprised him. She was in New York. Later on, I offered to give a deposition, which they didn't need because they sued her that she was stealing his money after he died. And she wasn't.
I remember.
She gave him an extra few years. And, you know, that's pretty much wonderful conversation. That's my Groucho story. You take over your own show.